This important video is going to make your logo design process so much easier and way more efficient. And that's because I have some technical tips and hacks just for you. For example, right here, I've got a logo design that I've made, but there's one crucial thing every logo designer should do. So head up to Window and then open up the Actions panel. Okay, cool. So now create a new action and call it something like Scale Test. And once you hit record, you're now recording every single action that we do in Illustrator. And I'm going to duplicate my logo with the Alt Option key and then use the scale tool to bring down the scale to 75% of the original. You just hit enter when you have the scale tool. And I'm going to keep doing this several more times, all while Illustrator is recording my process over in the Actions panel. We want to do this as a logo designer because even if our logo looks really neat and it does actually apply to the brief, it may not perform well at small scales or sometimes even at large scales. Okay, so once you're finished, just click stop in the Actions panel. Now you have yourself a very quick way to scale test any logo design. You just highlight your design and then you click play here and boom, scaled designs really, really fast. And of course, this does work on pretty much anything in Adobe Illustrator. So here's a handy artboard hack that very few designers know about. And this really helps for exporting designs and then sending them to the clients. So I'm going to drag my logo off to the artboard for a moment and make sure it's still highlighted. Then come and grab the artboard tool here. If you hold down shift, you'll notice the cursor icon changes as you can see right here. And then if you click the logo, Illustrator will make a perfect artboard that touches the edges precisely on your design. And you can then select the original artboard and delete it by pressing backspace if you want to. And this will leave the new artboard as a dominant one on your project. Again, this does help if you want a precise artboard and want to export the design in this way. Perhaps for your client to say, "Ooh, great job." Or maybe something along the lines of, "Nah, please make it pop." And one of the tools for being laser focused in your workflow is actually Miro. It's a leading visual collaboration platform that enables any design team to create awesome things together. And that's wherever they are in the world. With this online whiteboard, teams can actually work in sync, in flow, and generate ideas together, even in remote, distributed, and hybrid work environments. The cool thing about Miro is that it's actually an all-in-one tool that connects you to over 100 apps, streaming your workflow down to the T. It also has a smart meetings function where you can run high-impact meetings or workshops with ease. But one of the main things that I found with Miro is actually how it enables me to be focused and organized completely throughout the day. As I mentioned at the start of the video, I like to wake up and have active goals to work on the day ahead. Miro has this really cool virtual sticky notes function that looks authentic with drop shadows and everything. And so that means no more sticky note dramas in the workplace for me or for you. I also really love their mind maps for going through my design process. Like I always say, a designer without a design process is like a baker without a recipe. And that never ends well. But yeah, you can actually try out Miro for yourself and see how your daily workflow can benefit just by clicking the link in the description box below. This next logo process is great for those creative typographic logo design projects that you might actually have. Now here's some pretty neat logo type. And if you're wondering, this typeface is Pacifico. Okay, so with your logo type selected, come to the free transform tool, hold down a click, and then navigate to the puppet warp tool. And we're going to use this tool in combination with another one for a perfect match in Illustrator. But with this puppet warp tool, you will have some anchors already set up on your typography, but we can click to add new nodes or anchors like so. Adding nodes would allow your logo type to remain locked in position in that area while you make edits in other areas. And this can be a lot of fun, and you can take somewhat generic and regimented typography and really add some character to it. However, in doing so, you might notice some unwanted effects as seen right here. For these, I like to press A for the direct selection tool and then grab the smooth tool. You might want to actually double click the tool in the toolbar and adjust the smooth settings. But yeah, when you use these two tools in combination in unison, you can create some original and interesting logo type. When designing a logo, people often gravitate to the pen tool for some reason. And sure, this is a valid method, but an easy and a clean way to design logos is to make use of preset shapes. As an example here, I'm working with a rectangle. But what logo do you think this is going to end up to be? But yeah, using shapes is not only quick, it allows a designer to ensure the logo is clean and precise. And there is sort of a golden rule or good tip to remember, which we will briefly talk about now. And yeah, of course, this is the Mitsubishi logo. So, as a general rule, brands that are based around man-made products or a logo that wants to appear man-made needs to use straight-edged, geometric shapes and lines as a good choice. For designs that want to appear natural and organic or depict living beings, curvy and smooth lines or shapes are a better option. And this is only a general rule though, of course. This is an absolutely essential part of my logo design process, and so I must mention it in today's video. Using the Illustrator mirror option saves so much time, it's actually ridiculous. It allows me to make sure my symmetrical designs are 100% precise and ultra clean. I originally designed this logo before Adobe added the mirror function to Illustrator, but now it's there, I always use it. Another part of my process that is so essential but which I have spoken about before is the multiple screens process. In Illustrator, just open up your document in two more windows and then arrange it however you want. Yeah, I know, I've mentioned this before, but I want to show my current process for designing logos in 2023 in Illustrator, and this is a crucial part of the process for me. In logo designing, it's really crucial to know the unwritten golden laws of logo designing, and if you want to learn those, just click the video on screen. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.